which is, by the way, are the most talked about magical creatures. And they don't even die easy. You have to burn them. The best story that comes to my mind is of Ansel and Gretel, the German fairy tale written by the Grimm brothers. Do you remember how these children tricked the old blind witch and pushed her into the oven? But whoever thought that witches could live in water too? Today's story is about one such water witch. Once upon a time, there lived an evil water witch in a certain lake. She was well known to kidnap little children playing near the lake. It so happened that one day a boy and his sister happened to play near that very lake. Suddenly, they both tumbled and fell into the lake. Now, they were caught by this nasty witch. The witch took the children to her house in a faraway forest. They were made the slaves of the witch, and she made them work their heads off. She didn't even give them proper meals to eat. Worse still, the witch gave them impossible tasks to do. The boy was made to cut a certain tree with a blunt axe, and his sister was made to fill water in a bottomless tub. Now the children grew so fed up of the witch, but they could not escape as the witch had kept a close watch over them. One lucky day, the witch had to go out for an important task, and as usual, she cast a magical spell on the door of her house so that the children would not escape. But she forgot all about the window. And soon as she was gone, the children escaped. When the witch came home, she was furious, and she decided to go looking for her slaves. The children, however, had not reached very far away from the house. They saw the witch following them. But they were very intelligent kids. They had stolen a few magical things from the witch's house before escaping. The girl threw back a magical hairbrush that immediately turned into a huge brush mountain with thousands and thousands of bristles over it. The witch found it so difficult to climb the brush mountain, but nevertheless, she used her magic and appeared on the other side of the mountain. As soon as the children saw the witch, the boy threw back a magical comb that turned into a huge combed mountain with thousands of spokes on it. But the cunning witch used her magic again to get her way through. The little girl then threw back a magical mirror that turned into a mirror mountain. But this time, the witch could not destroy the mirror mountain with her magic. She tried to climb the mirror mountain, but the glass was so smooth that she kept sliding down. The witch knew that her magical axe would surely destroy the mountain. And so she hurried back home to bring the axe and destroyed the mirror mountain with it. But by then, the children had long gone far away from her. The angry witch then returned to the lake again. She still lives in that lake, waiting for little children to play near it so that she can make them her slaves.